So let's see, as Magnus notices that painting over there.
The one to the left. And then you look over there and you see this nudity.
Episode. How are you doing? Welcome to Stories of My Life. So today I'm meeting my friend Magnus at Gamla Stan at 11 o'clock in half an hour, so I better step on it. We are going to go to Liljevalchs konsthall, I think. Liljevalchs is an art exhibition, and we're going to see the spring exhibition, I think. We've never been there, me nor him. So join us as we face art. Sort of. Here's art, and we are here, and we sort of like art. Oh, that's art. This time Magnus is early, and I'm not late. He's early. How very weird. Hello.
Hello.
How are you? I'm not late, am I? I'm not late. People, here we are at Djurgården, and this is Magnus, and we are about to go into this museum for the very first time. Donde está la primavera, porco Dio?
Are you talking to my neck?
Yes, are you excitement?
This is a museum. I'm doing a story today. This is Jukka.
Hello.
And this is the museum.
What's the name of the museum? Put my stuff in the locker, and this is the way you do it. It's not really complicated. You just have to be of average smartness, and I am not. Oh, hello. To find our way. We just come up there, and this is a map. We're not quite sure. Maybe we should just like walk around and start doing it in earnest later.
What's that? What?
Maybe we should just sort of look, just walk quickly around just to see the place and then start.
Okay.
We did a walk through of the whole place and now we're in the first room where they have old posters of exhibitions here, and this is erotic art, so that's where he goes.
So that's not erotic in our time.
Well, it's a sort of a kiss, isn't it?
Sort of.
Well,
is it two females?
I'm not sure.
I'm upset.
Tell the people why you are upset.
Apparently, this is ordinary people's paintings and stuff. So yes. It's amateur evening.
Well, they could be artists anyway, couldn't they? And I mean, they could
but
be
not professional ones. Oh, yeah, you said they could, but. Who is that?
These are quite interesting. They're sort of strips of paper in the shape of dead animals. Shout out to my cousin Karina and Bosse. This is from my hometown. These are the silos, I think they're called, from inside. This is a marathon in Petit Point. This is fantastic.
Wow.
So I think Magnus hates most of this because he doesn't think it's art, and I don't tell him that, but it is sort of artists. It's very subjective, but he's sort of,
no.
We've found some art that Magnus likes, especially this. This is in Tartia. It's made from thin layers of wood. And this he approves of. Sculpture we call At Ulf's Place. Doing to his car, but he's putting a piece of his anatomy into the exhaust pipe of the car, and it's called Farmer Looking for Wife. This one is called Online Dating, and there's a line with a dog, I don't know. And this one, someone is mooning, I don't know what it is, and I don't know if this is love, but it's sure a moment in time. Let's see, as Magnus notices that painting over there.
The one to the left?
And then you look over there and you see this
nudity.
It's called Pandemic, and this one is also called Pandemic Working from Home. Sort of erotic, so Magnus liked that very much. And I wonder what he'd say when he notices this. Decided. Ah, here we are. Oh my God, we sat there when we were at the restaurant last. So, okay, some people really don't see us, no. This is kind of, we decided we need food because it's all art and no food makes us. Oh! Okay, so this I like. Again, in the restaurant where we were a couple of days ago. Magnus is. Because this is the vegan part of the restaurant. Magnus is going to another part and coming back here. I want to sit down there. Where we were a couple of minutes ago. So this is the old building and this is the new building. The first day without painkillers and I'm feeling some discomfort. It's not really painful, well it is, but I think I have a tolerance for pain. People think I'm part of art. So it doesn't really hurt, it's more like a gnawing feeling. I ordered soup for obvious reasons. Over there is another restaurant where Magnus is buying some feta cheese pie thing. And here he comes with his feta cheese and tomato pie? Is it a pie?
It's a pie.
Is it a pie?
Yeah. I did not tell you.
I forgot. I just said.
Tomato feta pie.
I just heard feta cheese and then I thought of ramen without eggs. I thought it would be soupier, but
that's good. And Magnus is really in the mood for art.
I'm inside and people are sitting where we just sat. So, and this is art. This is a piece of clay, a plaster called August Strindberg. Talking about wisdom tooth.
removal.
And this is a carpet made out of metal. I bet it's called kombucha or something. It's called kombucha. I saw it instantaneously. Magnus, on the other hand, was thinking, oh, that's a bird cage. Where's the bird? Oh, the bird cage is broken. And he really likes listening to stuff, hoping there's music.
Not as exciting as the other bedroom.
This is called Never Alone. It's half a table and a chair in front of a mirror. So when you sit down, it's like you're eating with someone else. So now this is the epicenter of the music.
The right,
yes. The what?
The right way.
Is there a wrong way?
There's always a wrong way. Temporary.
I think when an artist or a painter call their work sort of like they name it without title or titleless or print number 4, I think that's just laziness. You should always try to find some interesting name for it, whatever it is. That's just me, but yes, laziness. This one is kind of interesting. This is called The Phantom and the Socialist Revolution. This one is called To the End of the Road, but then someone wrote The Last Fart on it. I think this is the last. Yes, it is. Oh. So, this carpet, it is an actual carpet. It says, is this long enough?
The balcony in 1991.
There's another thing that's a cue to my where I was. This one says, upphittad på Grönhögens kalkbrott av K. Palén. Grönhögen is a little sort of town, no, a village on Öland where I come from. So this is also something to do with Öland. All those artists just flocking to the island. We are done with the old part of the museum, which is the spring salon. Now we're going to go into the new part. This is about the new part. Favorite, so I might buy it for him.
Yes, I think that one is even better.
Yeah. So this is your favorite.
Yeah.
You said that was your favorite.
Both of them.
Well, you have to choose one.
No,
I bought that one for you because I thought.
I like it very much.
So, I bought it. Oh God, I'm going to sell. I've sold it already. I made some money. There's an exhibition here about Harold Lith. I never heard of him. Magnus find him quite intriguing. I thought Magnus didn't like paintings like this.
Oh, yes.
And like that. Yeah. And like that. But he does. In here is a picture of when they hung these things. The painters seem to be alive still. It's over there. And they just showed a picture of how many paintings that were sort of hung upside down or in the wrong way when they didn't know which way was up. What's the name of the artist?
Harold Lith. Well, you can sort of say in Swedish, Harald Lith.
Harald.
Oh.
Lith.
Mean name.
Anyway, I'm mad about the floor. I'm mad about the ceiling.
And I'm like, I'm mad about the boy. And I'm quite like the paintings as well. We've been talking art for hours. We played a game in here. We tried to decide which our favorite paintings is. This is my favorite painting in this room. This is Magnus' favorite painting in this room. We've done this whole house. Oh, look, we're here again. And now we're going to get our jackets, then we're going to go to the gift shop, and then we're going to say goodbye, and I'm going to go to work. Art. You can't resist it. We're done, and we are now going to go to the gift shop, and we thought it's easier to go, because the gift shop is in the sort of new part of the building, a new building, even. So it's easier to go outside. Did you enjoy it?
Yeah, we're going to the tin can. I enjoyed it very much, especially the last part, because I think I'm not so fond in artists that are not maybe artists.
Thank you. Okay, so this is the building that Magnus calls the can, the tin can. To me, I think it's quite lovely, actually. Especially when you've been inside. He does not think so. So we are now in the gift shop. And it's not that big, considering it's really quite old.
It was the Liquor Museum's gift shop.
Yes, you've never been here.
No.
So there are socks with sort of... That's Andy Warhol, David Hockney. Don't know who that is. Read it upside down, you can read it. We didn't buy anything.
Do you buy things from those
gift shops?
Yeah,
sometimes I do. But here, I felt nothing sort of really appealed to me.
It wasn't a good gift shop.
No, I think they should have more stuff.
Yeah.
But maybe it's new, I don't know. They should, because it's a really old museum. It's over 100 years old, I think. So they really should have a lot of things they could pull.
So, yeah.
Goodbye. Time to say goodbye to Magnus. He is a little worried because we saw two church towers and we're not quite sure. We know from the museum we saw two church towers. We know one of them, but the other one we can't find. So he thinks there might...
No, we don't know the other one either.
Wasn't that the one in Tyska Kyrka?
But that was... We thought it was the German church because of the Stor Kyrka.
Oh, and the... Yes. No. So there are two churches. We don't know where they are.
Because you see the Stor Kyrka.
Yeah.
It's renovated now. So you could clear... And that one we saw wasn't renovated.
No. So anyway, I'll be seeing you on Monday.
Yeah.
For lots and lots of gin and games.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I'm going to buy... And some food.
Oh, food as well? Yes. Oh, nice. Because sometimes people get hungry. Goodbye. People, it's time. It's Friday. Let's go rain now.
A meeting on stage.
Let's hear me. I'm walking backwards into the meeting because... Minutes till the show starts. Lucas is... Here in Sweden, it's the International Waffle Day, and I think someone should have brought waffles to work, but someone didn't. But someone didn't even sort of think they could. And here they are, the true stars, Gustav and Polly, talking about something...
About
football.
Yes, we do.
Yes?
We love it.
Isn't it too cold for football?
No.
I mean,
No?
Yesterday it was like tropics here in Stockholm.
It was?
Yes.
Because we won.
Oh, I did not know that.
Oh, it was a very important...
What, game yesterday?
Yes.
Oh, sports. Sports is for morons.
It's only for theatre.
I'm only for theatre. I love it all. So, tomorrow you will be trying out French, I've heard.
Chicken?
Yeah?
Yes, very exciting.
It is exciting. Something's...
It's always been my dream to have this, you know...
I know.
My hair is too...
No, I think we can do it. Let me catch you.
Okay.
About to start. The actors are in the places. I am not in the right place. I shouldn't be here. I should be here. Let's go here. Here I am. Kit is about to... Yes, she's giving them the finger. That's the finger. Great work. Jerry. Hello. So you are somewhat of a mentor, aren't you?
Yes, I am. This is Nora.
Hello, Nora.
Nora Paulson with one S.
One S?
Yes.
And you're mentoring her?
Yes, she's with me yesterday and today and next week. Mm-hmm. And today she's wearing black.
Because she's backstage.
Yes, she's backstage. And yes, I have to have black. Yes.
Good. Welcome.
Thank you.
You want to be here. She just hasn't kidnapped you.
I want to be.
Okay, good. Because you made me sort of... I was nervous. People, I'm on my way to move a desk. That's all. Now it's time for dinner, which is the last of that great tofu I made, well, a week ago. Yeah, I know. Old food. Really interesting going on here with... She's talking and someone is... I was visiting David and he's not here. Then I hear someone... No. He's not there. Has he died?
Fast nu vill jag inte backa och förklara det, okej? Hur är det med julen?
So, she's showing what she's doing to her mentoree. And then she lost it, so... This is acting. Blah 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 blah. Still looking for David. Where is he? Oh, I can hear his voice. What are you doing down here?
Coffee time.
Oh my God.
We have a coffee machine, you don't know?
No, I didn't. Oh my God.
It peeped.
I think what happened was, usually I'm at David's room and listening to his ongoing monologues. I wasn't there because I was eating, so he sort of, who can listen to my monologue? So he looked up one of the actors and now he's sort of telling a story to the actor instead. I think that's what happened. You're the police woman now.
Now, tell me, Kerry.
Yes. Is this the last... Please, I mean... you're not going to play it anymore tonight.
Not tonight.
No.
No, this is the last. So yes. Now I'm going upstairs, take off my wig to become Gladys.
Oh,
and
Gladys...
She's a glamorous girl. She's a gold digger.
Fantastic.
Yes.
Yes. This people is acting. You do three roles and they're very different. They're all kind of blonde, though.
Yeah, kind of.
Started following me.
Yes, I did.
David tells me that I should see a picture called The Artist that came out in 2011. It's fantastic. He has seen it and then he's sitting here. Was it a silent movie? I'm not sure. He doesn't seem to remember anything about it.
Yes, I remember everything, but the story is so good that you don't notice there's no dialogue.
Oh. What happened during your big scene?
She's supposed to come in with two drinks on the tray, and they're fluffy and with the cream.
She enters the parties.
The drinks fell.
I think just one.
And it's so funny because it's It's so much theater. When a drink falls, yeah, and all the cream and everything is
still there. Yeah.
And she goes,
she is drunk.
And she's so drunk. I'm sorry.
The show's over. David is going home and I'm going down. See you tomorrow, David.
Hello.
Shake it. Take your food.
Hello.
Shake your food feather. I just want to show you the drinks. They look like that. And you can sort of... Yeah. It's concrete. So when they fall, they just, you know, makes a hole in the floor. Fantastic. Glorious. Heart-wrenching. Just going home and... The audience leaving the auditorium, and now the Iron Curtain is coming down. I'd like to thank you for joining me today in this fascinating story. Thank you for watching and for liking, commenting, subscribing and following. It really helps, and something to do with the internet and the algorithm, I think. So thank you so much.